In this video, I'll be discussing how columns within tables are created and managed in Dataverse for Teams. You can use one of two interfaces to manage columns. The Build Hub provides a Teams-based interface that has more attributes to customize the columns. Dataverse for Teams also has a streamlined experience called the Table Designer that makes some decisions for you. First, we'll add a column in the Design Hub. Click on the table name on the Build screen.
Click Edit.
And click Add Column. Display name is a required field. This is the friendly name for the column. This value can be changed after the column is saved. Name is a logical name used by the system for the column. Notice there's a prefix on the name. That prefix is your publisher ID and will be present on all columns you create. This value must be unique and cannot be changed after it's been saved. Data type lets you select the kind of data you want to store in the column. There are many types, and these are discussed in other videos. Depending on which data type you pick, there will be different attributes used to customize the column. The required field lets you specify if this field must be filled in when using the app UI. Optional means that the field is not required. Recommended is also not required, but in some UIs, it will place an icon next to the field to draw the user's attention. Required means you cannot complete a record in the app without it being filled in. This setting can be modified at any time. If you change a column to required after data has been entered, only the new records will require the data to be populated. If you open an old record, it will ask you to complete the required field before saving. Searchable lets you choose if you want the search functions in the apps to be able to search on the column. It is defaulted to on, but you may want to disable it on some fields, like multi-line text fields that are used for descriptions, or other columns that do not need to be queried. This can be changed at any time. Description allows you to enter up to a 300-character description for the column. This is an optional field and can be edited at any time. Advanced options will vary depending on which data type you chose. Click Done to close the column editor. Columns will not be saved until you save the table by clicking Save Table. You can add and manage multiple columns and then save the table all at once. Once saved, the table and column are ready for your data. Now let's use the Table Designer to add a column. You can use the Table Designer to add and manage columns if you are already in the App Creator. Click the Data section in the left-hand navigation and click on the name of the table you want to edit. You can either click the plus next to the last column on the table or click Add Column from the top of the page. Fill out the provided fields. Name is the display name for the column and can be edited at any time. Type lets you choose the data type. Not every single data type that is available in the Design Hub is available in the Table Designer. Some of the types require specific configurations that are only in the Design Hub. Advanced options will vary depending on which data type you select.
When you're finished, click Create.
You can immediately start entering data into your table and column. Now we've talked about modifying the columns and adding them, but to delete a column, there's a few things to remember. If a column is being used by an app, a Power Automate flow, a solution, or a Power Virtual Agent, you cannot delete it. When you delete a column, it deletes all of the data in the column, and there is no undelete option. To learn more about Dataverse, check out our other videos online.